Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel, Govind Narayan Purohit. I wish to extend my sincere thanks to all of you who have subscribed to my channel. If you have not already subscribed, kindly do subscribe to it so that you receive the notification of our videos very fast. Friends, in this channel, we are discussing on different topics on theriogenology, and in our today's topic, we'll discuss about the buffaloes of the world and their estrus and insemination. So let us start. You see, buffalo is an animal which is found in almost all the continents of the world, and buffalo is an animal which survives well under harsh climatic conditions, under conditions where there is a high disease resistance, and it's an animal which is considered to be a better converter of feed. Now, buffalo milk, 100 ml of the buffalo milk contains 237 calories, 17.3% calcium, 7.8% protein, 4.3% of vitamin A, phosphorus, potassium, magnesium, zinc, and many antioxidants. Buffalo milk is preferred for making cheese in many countries, including Italy. Now, we talk of the buffalo. The buffalo originates from the bovini, is a subclass of the bovines, and the Cincerus, or the group which includes the African wild buffalo, the Cincerus saphyr, and the Cincerus saphyr nanus. It includes the Bubalus arni, or the wild water buffalo, which is considered to be the forefather of most buffaloes. This buffalo was at one time present in the Shivalik hills of India, and it's from this buffalo it's considered that most buffaloes originated. Then there is the Bubalus depressicornis, the lowland ANOVA, which has a chromosome number ranging from 44 to 48. Bubalus quarlesi, or the mountain ANOVA, which has chromosome numbers again varying from 42 to 48. The Bubalus mindorensis, or the Tamara, which is in the IUCN red list because it's considered an endangered species and has chromosome numbers of 46. Then the Bubalus is the water buffalo, which inhabits many parts of the world, and it has two subtypes, the river buffalo, Bubalus, which has chromosome numbers of 50, and the Bubalus carbonensis, which is the swamp buffalo, which has chromosome numbers of 48. Then the Murrah, Nili-Ravi, and many other breeds of the river buffalo inhabit many parts of the world. And as the name indicates, the swamp buffalo is the work animal, and it's found in Southeast Asia. And then there is popularly known as the Carabaos. And then there is the Tidongbonga, which is a preferred buffalo in parts of Sulawesi and Malaysia. And then it's very popular because of the white and black, admixture of white and black color. Buffalo is considered the black gold in many countries, and the world population of buffaloes is approximately 207 million. And more than 97% are found in Asia, 2% in Africa, particularly Egypt, 0.7% in South America, and less than 0.2% are in Australia and Europe. India has 105 million buffaloes, which is 57% of the world's buffalo population. Now, in this figure, you can see how buffalo originated and how the buffalo spread to the parts of the world. The river buffalo, it spread from India to many parts of the world, including Africa, including Europe, including parts of South America, and then the countries, Gulf countries like Iran, Iraq, Turkey. This map shows the presence of buffaloes all over the world. You can see here the highest population is in India, and then India and Pakistan, and then the river buffalo is also found in the African countries, and then Gulf countries, South America, North America, Southeast Asia, and Australia. Countries with swamp buffalo include the Southeast Asia, Cambodia, China, Indonesia, Laos, Malaysia, Philippines, Sri Lanka, Thailand, and Vietnam, and Australia. Countries with river buffalo include the India, Pakistan, and then European countries like Greece, Italy, Bulgaria, Turkey, parts of South Africa, including Egypt, and then South America and North America. This graph shows the population of buffalo in terms of the overall livestock population in India. Buffalo constitute only 20.45% of the total livestock population, but they contribute 50% of India's total milk production. And then in this map, you can see buffaloes are spread all over the country with maximum numbers in Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, and then they are spread in Gujarat and nearly all other states of India. India has around 10 milch breeds of buffalo, including Murrah, Nili-Ravi, Jafarabadi, Surti, Mehsana, Badavari, Pandharpuri, and the most prized one is the Murrah buffalo. It's known for high milk production, and Murrah buffaloes from India have been imported, exported to many countries around the world. Then the Nili-Ravi buffalo, which is also known as the Panch Kalyani, which has five white markings over the head and the legs and the tail. Tail switch is also white. This buffalo is found in India and Pakistan. Then the Zafarabadi, Surti and Mehsana. These three buffaloes are popular in the Gujarat state of India. And then there is the Badavari buffalo, which is popular in Uttar Pradesh in India. And then the southern part of India has many buffaloes, the Nagpuri buffalo, the Pandharpuri buffalo, the Toda buffalo, and many other buffaloes. Then the Kundi buffalo, which is popular in Pakistan and is a very high producing buffalo. And then there are the Egyptian buffaloes in Egypt and the Mediterranean buffalo in Italy. The swamp buffalo, as the name suggests, is the principal work animal in many countries of Southeast Asia, and in some parts of India like Assam, they also have the swamp buffalo. The buffalo originates its name from its capacity to be used in agricultural purposes in swamp and marshy places. You can see here the agricultural implementations, agricultural practices being done using a swamp buffalo. So the swamp buffalo is the or popularly also known as the carabaos in Philippines and Thailand, and these are the principal work animals. Now we talk of some aspects of estrus. The puberty, the buffalo heifer attains puberty in 36 to 48 months, but with better management, puberty can occur a bit earlier. Now this is one of the problem of the buffalo, the delayed puberty. This table shows the age at puberty and age at first calving in buffalo heifers in different breeds. The Murrah of India, it has got age at puberty 16 to 40 months, body weight at puberty 300-355 kg, and age at first calving 37 to 57 months. Then the Nili-Ravi of India and Pakistan, it has got a slightly lower age at first puberty, a higher age at puberty, 450 to 419 kg, but a slightly lower age at first calving, 40 to 42 months. Then the Mediterranean Italian buffaloes, they have a lower age at puberty, and then a comparatively lower age at first calving also. The data on swamp buffaloes for age at first calving is scarcely available, and the swamp buffaloes of Cambodia, they have, it has been reported that they attain puberty at 36 months. Now we talk a bit of the reproductive physiology of the buffalo in terms of oestrus. Buffaloes are seasonally polyestrous. The oestrus cycle of the female buffalo is approximately 21 days in length, ranging from 17 to 24 days, and the duration of oestrus ranges from 19 to 24 hours, and sometimes even more than that. Ovulation occurs 24 to 48 hours, a mean 34 hours after the onset of oestrus, or 12 to 18 hours after the end of oestrus. This is the table showing the oestrus cycle length and duration of oestrus in buffaloes in different studies. For the Murrah buffalo in India, the cycle length ranges 28 to 41 days, and usually most of the buffaloes, they have a oestrus cycle length of 21 days. The duration of oestrus varies from 17 to 29 hours in Murrah buffaloes and 2 to 3 days in the Chinese swamp buffaloes. The Philippine carabaos, they have the cycle length ranging from 27.6 to 46 days, and the mean duration of oestrus is longer in the Philippine carabaos, 33.6 hours, 33.6 days. The duration of oestrus is around 24 hours in the Philippine carabaos. The African wild buffalo remains in oestrus for 5 to 6 days, the Cincerus saphirus, and cycles every 23 days. It has also been stated or mentioned that the African wild buffaloes, the Cincerus saphir, has a pro-oestrus period of 1 to 3 days. The breeding season of buffalo is during winter, the October to March, in most of the countries where the river buffaloes are kept. Buffaloes in countries near the equator, particularly countries like Argentina, which are near the equator, the buffaloes cycle throughout the year, but then their cyclicity is dependent on the availability of fodder. The carabaos are also considered to cycle throughout the year at some places. Now, these are the reproductive parameters of swamp and river buffaloes. The oestrus cycle length in swamp and river buffaloes, the oestrus duration a bit longer in the swamp, ovulation occurring 6 to 21 hours, and then after oestrus, and the fertilization rate is nearly similar. The blastocyst formation is also nearly similar. Conception rates are higher in the river buffalo, and implantation is considered to occur at around 25 days in the river buffalo. And the swamp buffalo also has a slightly higher gestation length of 321 to 330 days compared to 315 days in the river buffalo. Now, we talk of the signs of oestrus. Buffalo has a big problem of silent oestrus. It has poor overt expression of oestrus in a higher proportion of buffaloes, and this poses problems of oestrus detection and artificial insemination. A common thing is that buffaloes should be observed for oestrus during early morning and late evening, because they express oestrus during that time more frequently. Now, temporary teat engorgement is one of the principal sign of a buffalo in oestrus, and this is the you have just milked your buffalo, you have tied the calf away, and after some time of milking, suddenly there is accumulation of milk in the teats, what is known as the doki or the temporary teat engorgement. You can see here also the buffalo is showing temporary teat engorgement. Now this temporary teat engorgement, it appears 2 to 4 days before the estrus onset, and farmers should identify buffaloes, river buffaloes particularly, based on the appearance of temporary teat engorgement. If a buffalo is showing temporary teat engorgement, he should be awake that the buffalo is likely to be in estrus within 2 to 4 days. Then other signs like switching of her tail onto one side and slight cervicovaginal discharge. The cervicovaginal discharge is scanty and it's grayish in color, and many a times it is evident when the buffalo sits rather than when the buffalo is standing. The estrus expression in terms of overt expression or bellowing is seen only in a small proportion of buffaloes. A large proportion of buffaloes do not evidence the bellowing sign, because and this is known as the silent estrus. Then sometimes you can notice the discharge on stick on the perineum or on the tail, and as I said earlier that the discharge is evident when the buffalo sits. Particularly many of the river buffaloes have showing the signs in the presence of a buffalo bull. Now it has also been seen in the villages that if your buffalo is in estrus and if it's not tied properly, then it will move around to a large distance in search of a male buffalo. A lot of work on the pheromones have been done in the male buffalo by studies done by Dr. Archunan and other groups, and but a little work has been done on the pheromones or the detection of male pheromones of the male buffalo by the female buffalo. But it has been seen in the field that if your buffalo is not tied properly, it is in estrus, it will move around to even sometimes to many kilometers in search of a male buffalo. Then estrus signs in swam buffaloes are even lesser. A swam buffalo may raise her tail, show some discharge, and then a male swam buffalo will follow a female buffalo which is in estrus, and it will mount the female swam buffalo and give a mating. Then the Lehman response is also shown by the male swam buffalo when they smell the female swam buffaloes. Buffalo farmers often bring their swam buffalo farmers often bring their female buffaloes for insemination based on some signs like the switching of the tail, some discharge or frequent urination, and this is considered to, and then when they bring their animal to the vet, he can examine the animal and know the status of estrus by knowing the intense coiling of the uterine horns and then presence of a follicle. And buffaloes for restraint, for examination using transrectal palpation, are restrained by tying ropes on the forelegs rather than on the hind legs. Now, a frequent problem with buffalo breeding during natural mating is that farmers state that a buffalo bull smells the buffalo in estrus but does not provide a service. And what should they do? Now, it's because still a large number of the riverine buffaloes and the swamp buffaloes as well are covered by natural mating. So this problem has to be addressed. And so I must say that if the buffalo bull is a sluggish breeder, and if it's aged, or if it has given 3 to 4 or more number of services that day, it will show little of interest in your buffalo in estrus. So if the male buffalo is smelling it but not providing a service, the farmer should take his animal to the vet and get it examined. And if it is in estrus, then it should be inseminated. Or if he doesn't want that, then he can note down that date, and from 21 days from that day date, he must be aware that next 21 days my buffalo will return to estrus. But it's better to take the buffalo to a nearby vet who would examine and would know the status of the estrus in that buffalo and perform an artificial insemination. Buffaloes also evidence the Fleeman response, cajoling of the upper lip. And this is detecting the pheromones, the volatile fatty acids secreted in the urine and the vaginal secretions, and sometimes even in the saliva. Now, a frequent question by buffalo farmers is when to breed their buffalo. You see, there is a popular belief that buffalo should be mated with a buffalo bull when the estrus has nearly gone off, but this is not proper. They must breed the buffalo 12 hours after the first detection of the estrus, and they should take their buffalo to the buffalo bull if they require, or if they intend to have a natural mating, they should take. Now you can see the buffalo bull mounts, and then now it has provided the thrust. If the buffalo bull has provided the thrust, it must be clear that now, yes, my buffalo has been mated through natural mating. Now, for artificial insemination in the buffalo, using cryopreserved semen, the thawing temperatures are 37 degrees for 15 seconds, and it's suggested that after transrectal palpation, artificial insemination must be done at 12 and 24 hours of standing estrus. Now, buffalo heifers have very small uterine horns. Sometimes it's difficult to pass the AI gun. It's suggested to just manipulate your hand in the rectum back forth, so that if the vaginal folds, which are preventing the passage of the AI gun, they become straightened, and then you just locate the os externus, and instead of passing it in the fornix, you just move this hand and slightly retract the AI gun, and then introduce in the os, and then pass it in the passing through the cervix and depositing the semen in the body of the uterus. Buffalo heifers particularly will have poor signs of estrus, and it's suggested that if there are some changes, some behavioral changes in the heifers, they must report their heifers to the qualified veterinarians, who will examine and then perform a artificial insemination if it is if the buffalo is in estrus. Many a times when performing or when organizing some infertility camps, you examine some buffalo heifers or even adult buffaloes on that day, and you will find a few or many of them are in estrus on that day. Particularly during winter months, if you are organizing an infertility camp, you must take with you the frozen semen so that you can perform inseminations as well. The crossbreeding of the swamp buffalo Crossbreeding of the two types of the buffaloes produce fertile hybrids with deployed number of chromosomes 2N is equal to 49. The crossbreeding of buffalo has been done to improve milk and meat potential of swamp buffaloes with river buffaloes in countries like China, Philippines, Vietnam, Malaysia, Thailand, Indonesia and Brazil. The introduction of riverine buffalo genetic materials into distinctly swamp buffalo populated countries of China and Southeast Asia started as early as 1917 in the form of both live animals and the transport of frozen semen. Now, this table, it shows how frozen semen doses were transported from one country to other, from Pakistan in 1987, the Nili-Ravi, around 1000 frozen semen straws were imported. Again in 1982, Murrah from Pakistan, 1000 doses. In 1984, Murrah, 1000 doses from India. 1985, Murrah, 1000 doses. And then India, 2013, Murrah, 1000 doses. And from Italy, Italian Mediterranean buffalo is also becoming popular. And 5000 doses were imported to Southeast Asia. And then from in Thailand also, the Murrah doses were imported. Then AI of swamp buffalo, similar to what is being performed in the river buffalo, but the restraint has to be done properly, and then one can perform artificial insemination in these buffaloes using both AI has been performed in swamp buffaloes using the swamp buffalo semen or the river buffalo semen for improvement. So, what care must be taken after insemination? Farmers often ask that whether or not they should milk their buffaloes. There is no problem in milking their buffaloes, but it's advisable to feed green fodder, and then do not just use a stick to make your buffaloes have some stress. Or do not make the buffaloes run after artificial insemination so that the buffalo is not under stress. And although the conception rates with natural mating and artificial insemination as well are high with buffalo, and one can easily perform artificial insemination, and this is the care which farmers should take after artificial insemination. During summer months, if your buffalo is in estrus, you make the buffalo swim in ponds, or you can shower water on its head or on the entire body to make her cool so that the conception rate increases. Then a problem is insemination of the silent estrus buffaloes. If a farmer is very sure that the buffalo is in estrus, he can take his animal to the veterinarian who will perform a transrectal examination, and if the buffalo is in estrus, if it has good tonicity in the uterus, there is coiling of the uterine horns and the presence of a follicle, he can perform insemination. But many a times the difficulty is that the farmers do not know. So if a farmer suspects his animal to be in estrus on that particular day, he must be more cautious, more vigilant of noting the signs. And if there is a drop in milk, if there is frequent urination, switching of the tail, he must, and then the temporary teat engorgement, he must be cautious that probably his buffalo is in estrus. And he should bring his animals to the insemination centers for insemination. Then there is a frequent question from farmers, if the buffalo has been mated with a buffalo bull or inseminated with frozen semen, yet it fails to conceive. Repeat breeding is less common in the buffalo population, and the person who is performing the artificial insemination, if he notices some pathology in the uterus, then artificial insemination should be avoided and the animal should be properly treated first and then inseminated in the subsequent estrus. Sometimes it becomes difficult if the buffalo is having some problems of ovulation, then appropriate hormonal therapy can be administered by the qualified vets who can help the farmer in getting their buffaloes pregnant. Then there is a frequent question that can a large number of buffaloes be brought into estrus during the breeding season on the same day? Yes, a large number of buffaloes can be brought to estrus on the same day by using estrus synchronization protocols. A large number of protocols are available, but the offspring protocol has become very popular in buffaloes during the breeding season, and one can easily cycle a large number of buffaloes on the same day with a tight synchrony. The farmers are advised to meet their vet and perform the estrus synchronization protocols during summer months, hot summer months. Most of the protocols do not work efficiently, and the protocols utilizing the progesterone implants should be incorporated in the estrus synchronization protocols so that you get some better results. Otherwise, estrus synchronization is usually performed during the breeding season, during the shorter days, during the winter months, so that buffaloes they can conceive on one day using the estrus synchronization protocols. And it's very good. One can get his large number of buffaloes inseminated on the same day, right? So, friends, if you like my video, kindly share it, kindly give your likes, kindly give your comments, share the video and subscribe to it if you like it. This is my channel, Govind Narayan Purohit. You can contact me at my email gnpobs@gmail.com. I will be glad to receive your queries and to answer them. So thank you very much. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.